Dear students, let us study second part of unit number 3, that is filters and attenuators. What are filters? Filters are nothing but the circuits which are possessing the property of differentiating between alternating currents of different frequencies, freely passing those within a particular range, while almost suppressing other frequencies. Filters were widely used in variety of circuits like voice communication, carrier frequencies, telephonic circuits and so on. Resonant circuits will select relatively narrow bands of frequencies and reject all the other frequencies, while filters provides substantially constant transmission over the band which they are used for. Important characteristics of all filters is that they are constructed from purely reactive elements like inductors and capacitors. Otherwise, attenuation could not be achieved. Okay, therefore, keep in mind that always reactive elements are used to construct filters. A filter can be defined as a network which in its ideal form has almost one range of frequency in which attenuation is zero, and at least one range of frequencies for which attenuation is infinite. That is, one range of frequencies will be passed and one range of frequencies will be blocked. A range of frequency where attenuation is zero is called as a passband, whereas a range of frequencies where attenuation is there is infinite attenuation is called as the attenuation band or stop band. Frequencies which separate attenuation band and pass band are called as cutoff frequencies, FC. So filters are sometimes classified according to the elements used. So if you are using only reactive elements, filters are called as passive filters, and along with the passive elements, if you are using op amp or some active elements, the filters are called as active filters. Passive filters consist of only reactive elements like inductors, capacitors, resistors and so on, and sometimes they may be arranged in series, sometimes they may be arranged in parallel LC combinations. T and pi, these basic arrangements are used for passive filters. This we are seeing in unit number 3, initial part. What is the T network and what is the pi network? Active filters have some advantages based on some op amps and transistors. They provide some gain parameters, and also they avoid inductors which are bulky. That's why sometimes active filters are preferred. In our syllabus, we have passive filters, so we'll concentrate on passive filters. These are some characteristics of filters, like passband characteristics. Passband, number one, passband characteristics. Filters should have minimum attenuation in this passband, means it should allow this range of frequencies. Stop band, filter should have maximum attenuation in this stop band. Cutoff frequency, the filter should have frequency distinguishing property in the passband or stop band. It should be able to identify lower as well as higher cutoff frequencies of transmitting signals through it. The transition frequency regions between the passband and stop band must be very small. Next, characteristic impedance. Characteristic impedance Z0 of a filter matches with the circuit to which it is connected throughout the passband. This prevents reflection loss in the combination. Special attention must be taken for choosing a filter so that it can be inserted into a given line or between two pieces of equipment. Types of filters. There are four common types of the filters as shown in diagram. First one is low pass filter. Second one is high pass filter. Third one is band pass filter, and the fourth one is band elimination filter. Now, for remembering these filter types, these kinds of diagrams are drawn. In these diagrams or in these graphs, we have attenuation on y-axis and frequency on x-axis. Attenuation stands for reduction in the amplitude. So if there is attenuation on y-axis and there is frequency on x-axis, figure number A represents ideal low pass filter. That is in the pass band before frequency fc, all the elements will be easily transferred, and after the frequency fc, all the frequency waves are blocked. Similarly for high pass filter, high pass filter stands for it will transfer higher range of frequencies and it will block lower range of frequencies. So if we refer figure B, there is attenuation on y-axis, so there should be high attenuation for lower frequencies and low attenuation for higher range of frequencies. So figure B represents ideal high pass filter. Now ideal band pass filter, there will be high attenuation above and below the range of frequencies, and there is very low attenuation for pass band frequencies. The way we have drawn graphs for graphs between attenuation and frequency, we can also draw a graph between gain and frequencies. So this gain and frequency graph will be exactly opposite to the graphs which are given in the figure. That is, if we define a low pass filter, it will pass lower frequencies and it will block higher frequencies. So higher attenuation will be offered for higher frequencies if I am having a low pass filter. Similarly, it can be drawn for high pass filter and band pass filter. Now the last type of the filter is nothing but band elimination filter. The band elimination filter may be represented by the graph shown in figure. There is attenuation on y-axis and there is frequency on the x-axis. So for a particular band of frequencies, it offers very high attenuation, and for remaining frequencies it offers very low attenuation. So remaining frequencies will be passed on and a particular range of frequencies can be blocked with the help of the band elimination filter. So in this way we can have four different types of the filter. First one, low pass. Second one, high pass. Third one, band pass filter. And the last one, band stop filter or the elimination filter. We will see one by one how to design this filter, how characteristic impedance and propagation constant of the filters can be derived, and so on.